Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel, Knowledge Academy. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the TSPSC General Study Solutions in a very detailed manner. If you like the content of our channel, then please do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon button. So whenever we upload a new video, the direct comes from your mobile. If any improvement is needed in every lecture, then please do comment in the comment section. We will definitely need all those improvements in the coming lectures. So why to waste more time? So let's get started. So now we are going to solve the 41 question. See the question here. What is the guiding principle behind the establishment of Niti Aayog? So what is the guiding principle behind the establishment of the Niti Aayog? Option A, collateral federalism. Option B, competitive federalism. Option C, compulsive federalism. Option D, cooperative federalism. So out of the four options, option D, cooperative federalism, is the correct solution of this question. So let's discuss something more about this one. Now we will discuss some of the important facts of the Niti Aayog. So Niti is nothing but the full form of Niti Aayog means National Institute for Transforming India. So the full form of Niti is nothing but National Institute of Transforming India. So therefore here it was established. It was established on the 1st January 2015. So therefore it was established on the date 1st Jan 2015 and it was replaced. It is replaced the Planning Commission. This was already discussed in the previous lecture. So the Niti Aayog was replaced the Planning Commission. So therefore now here one of the guiding principle of the Niti Aayog is nothing but cooperative federalism. Cooperative federalism is the one of the guiding principle of the Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog. This is the cooperative federalism is the one of the guiding principle of the Niti Aayog. So now we will understand what is the meaning of the federalism. The meaning of federalism is nothing but it is an agreement. It is an agreement between the central government and the state government. So federalism is nothing but it is an agreement between the central government and the state government in order to do some of the important projects. So this is the agreement between the central government and the state government. See here, suppose there is central government. So now central government gives funds to the state government in order to build any highways on this state. So any projects, if the central government wants to build in the state, then it will give funds to the state government. And the duty of the state government is to maintain the construction and the maintenance process as per the goal set by the central government. So whatever the goal set by the central government, the state government has to do the construction and the maintenance process within the particular dates, which are the goals set by the central government. So therefore, the central government gives the funds and also it sets the goals in order to accomplish in a within limited period of time. So the state government has a full responsibility in the construction and the maintenance process in order to complete the construction within the limited time. The time was set by the period of construction was set by the central government. So here this is an agreement. So it's an agreement between the central government and the state government. So that is why cooperative means they have to mutually understand and do the work in a simplified manner. That's why it is called as a cooperative federalism. They need to do an agreement in order to do the projects in the state government. So it is called as a cooperative federalism. It is one of the guiding principle of the Niti Aayog. So here Niti Aayog is also called as it is a policy think tank of government of India. So Niti Aayog is nothing but it is a policy think tank of government of India. So therefore this will give the ideas what to do, what are the projects in order to do in a particular state. All these things are given by the Niti Aayog. So here the headquarters of the Niti Aayog is present in the New Delhi and the chairperson is nothing but a Prime Minister. So therefore the present Prime Minister is Narendra Modi. So always the chairman of the Niti Aayog is the Prime Minister. So the present Prime Minister is Narendra Modi and the vice chairman is Rajiv Kumar. So presently the vice chairman of Niti Aayog is nothing but Rajiv Kumar and the CEO of the Niti Aayog is Amitabh Kant. So it is a very very important question. In any examination they will ask who is the present CEO of the Niti Aayog. Then it is Amitabh Kant. And also they will ask on which date it was established. It means from 1 Jan 2015 and they will ask it replaced what type of commission. Then we have to say it replaced the Planning Commission. So these are the important facts of the Niti Aayog. So now we are going to solve the 42nd question. So see the question here. The Speaker of Assembly submits his resignation to. So the Speaker of the Assembly submits his resignation to. Option A, Chief Minister. Option B, Governor. Option C, Deputy Speaker. Option D, Judge of High Court. So what are the four options? Option C, Deputy Speaker. So the Speaker of the Lok Sabha will submit his resignation to the Deputy Speaker. So let's discuss something more about this one. So now we'll discuss something more about this one. See, the president gives his resignation. The president gives his resignation to the vice president. And similarly, the vice president gives his resignation to the president. So that is what WRO indicates. So the president gives his resignation to the vice president, and the vice president gives the resignation to the president. And similarly, the prime minister, judge of the Supreme Court, governor, and judge of High Court, all these four people gives the resignation to the president of India. So therefore, the prime minister, judge of the Supreme Court, governor, and judge of High Court gives his resignation to the president. And similarly, the speaker of assembly gives his resignation to the deputy speaker of assembly. And similarly, deputy speaker of assembly gives his resignation to the speaker of assembly. So this is what they asked in the question, and there is a high probability to ask these type of questions is also. So therefore, that's why I explained this also in a very detailed manner. So the speaker of assembly gives his resignation to the deputy speaker of assembly, and the deputy speaker of assembly gives his resignation to the speaker of assembly. So for the Lok Sabha, the present speaker of the Lok Sabha is Om Birla. The present speaker of the Lok Sabha is Om Birla. He belongs to the BJP party, and the salary is 2.5 lakh per month. So therefore, the deputy speaker, so now the deputy speaker post is vacant. Present now, the deputy speaker post is a vacant seat. So therefore, for the Rajya Sabha, the present speaker is Vice President of India, is nothing but Venkaiah Naidu. He belongs to the party BJP. And similarly, the deputy speaker of the Rajya Sabha is Harivansh Narayan Singh, and he belongs to the party Janata Dal. So therefore, this is the important facts of the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, the speakers and the deputy speakers. You need to remember, all these type of questions will be asked in a regular competitive examination. So now we are going to solve the 43rd question. See the question here. What is 0 hour in parliament? So there are four options here. Out of the four options, the correct option I am going to tell you is the period after the question hour around 12 noon to discuss any important matter with the prior notice to the speaker. So out of the four options, the correct option I am going to say here, the period after the question hour around 12 noon to discuss any important matter with the prior notice to the speaker. So this is the correct solution of this question. So let's discuss something more facts about this one. First, we will learn some of the important facts of the parliament, and then we will learn what are the different types of hours which are present in the parliament. See, the parliament conducts three sessions in every year. So parliament is going to conduct the three sessions in each and every year. The first session is budget session, and the second is monsoon session, and the third is winter session. These are the three sessions which are going to make happen in every year in a parliament. So the budget session from Jan or February to the May, the period is this one, Jan or Feb to the May period. And similarly, the monsoon session is from July to August or September. And similarly, the winter session from November to December. So these are the three different sessions which are held in a parliament each and every year, and the respective period. See, now we are going to learn about the different hours which are present in the parliament. So question hour is also called as a first hour of the parliament, because in this hour, the MPs, the members of parliaments, are going to ask the questions to the ministers of the respective department, and they want them to be accountable for their work. So therefore, the MPs are going to ask the questions to the minister to make them accountable for their work. So in this hour, they will ask the questions. And similarly, now let's come to the 0 hour. So 0 hour is always around 30 minutes. The allocation period is the period which is allocated to the 0 hours is only 30 minutes. In this 30 minutes only, we are going to discuss some of the important urgent matters regarding the present current issues. So therefore, it is not mentioned in any parliamentary rule book. So regarding this hour, it is not mentioned in any parliamentary rule book, but even though the 30 minutes duration is allocated to the 0 hour, so that all the people can discuss about the important urgent topics. So to discuss current urgent topics, prior notice to speaker before 10 a.m. So always the person who wants to speak regarding the current issues, he has to give before 10 a.m. he need to give the proper notice to the speaker. Then only he can able to speak regarding this current issue in the 0 hour period, which is time allocation is 30 minutes and it starts around 12 p.m. So therefore it starts around 12 p.m. So the important facts of 0 hour is nothing but it starts around at 12 p.m. and it is not mentioned in any of the parliament rule book. And to discuss the current urgent topics with prior notice to the speaker. If you are not giving any prior notice, then you can't able to speak the current issues in this time allocated period. So therefore always you need to give the prior notice to the speaker before 10 a.m. So therefore these are the important facts of the 0 hour. So here and see, I have written again simply here, 0 hour is nothing but it is a period after the question hour. It's a period after question hour around 12 noon to discuss any important matters with prior notice to the speaker. So always you need to give the prior notice to the speaker, and around at 12 noon the session is going to happen. So it is around 30 minutes duration. So therefore you can discuss some of the important current issues in the parliament. So now we are going to solve what is 44th question. See the question here. Who appoints Comptroller and Auditor General of India? So Comptroller and Auditor General of India, it simply means CAG. So who appoints CAG of India? Option A, Minister of Finance. Option B, Prime Minister. Option C, Committee of Prime Minister and the Leader of Opposition. Option D, President of India. So out of the four options, option D, the President of India is going to appoint the CAG. It's nothing but Comptroller and Auditor General of India. So let's discuss something more about this one. So now we'll discuss some of the important facts of the CAG. CAG is nothing but a Controller and Auditor General of India. So the main function of this one is nothing but he is going to audit all the central government and the state government. Central government and the state government expenditures. So the what are the expenditures of the central government and the state government on the different projects? All the expenditure, this is going to audit each and everything in a very detailed manner. So this is the main function of the CAG. So here he was nominated by the Prime Minister. So therefore the Prime Minister is going to nominate him, but he was officially appointed by the President. So therefore the President of India is going to appoint this person, but he was nominated by the Prime Minister. So it is all about the CAG. So the present CAG. So the present CAG. So right now the present CAG of India is nothing but Sri Girish Chandra Murmu is the present CAG of India. So he is the present CAG of India. His name is Sri Girish Chandra Murmu is the present CAG of India. And his salary is around 2,50,000 rupees per month. So this is the salary of the CAG per month. And the time duration, the duration of his period is nothing but only 6 years or the 65 years. So whichever the thing comes earlier is that period is going to get retired. So therefore that period of this duration is only 6 years or the 65 years. So whichever the thing comes first, he has to get retired. Suppose if age is 62 years, at 62 years he was appointed as a CAG, means only up to 3 years he is going to get work. Means 65 years. Only suppose right now his age is 62 years. At the age of 62 years he got appointed as a CAG of India. Then he can only go up to the age of 65 years. Means only 3 years he can work. Suppose if his age is 62 years, then he can work only up to 65 years. So therefore he can work only the period of 3 years. Because 65 years is coming faster than the 3 years. So that's why he is going to work only up to 65 years. Suppose if his age is 58 years, at the age of 58 years he was appointed at the CAG, then he can work only up to 64 years because 6 years duration is completed. So that is what 6 years or 65 years, whichever the come first, he has to get retired in that age only. So therefore he can audit all the expenditures and of the central government and the state government. This is all I have told you in the briefly. So here the CAG is nothing but Controller and Auditor General of India. His term duration is only 6 years or the 65 years. And the present CAG of India is nothing but Sri Girish Chandra Murmu, and he was nominated by the Prime Minister and he was appointed by the President of India. And he is going to audit all the central government and the state government expenditure on the different types of projects. So now we are going to solve the 45th question. See the question here. Kalaji Narayan Rao was conferred with. Yes, conferred means nothing but what award he was received. So Kalaji Narayan was conferred with. Option A, Padma Sri. Option B, Padma Bhushan. Option C, Padma Vibhushan. Option D, Kala Karuna. So out of the four options, option C, Padma Vibhushan. So Kalaji Narayan Rao was received the Padma Vibhushan. So let's discuss something more about this person. So now we'll discuss some of the important facts of the Kalaji Narayan Rao. He was born on the 9th September 1914 in the Warangal. So in the Warangal place he was born on the date of 9th September 1914. So here his actual name is, the actual name of the Kalaji Narayan Rao is nothing but Raghuveer Narayan Lakshmikant Srinivasa Rama Raja Kaloji. So this is the actual name of the Kalaji Narayan Rao. So Raghuveer Narayan Lakshmikant Srinivasa Rama Raja Kaloji. It is the actual name of the Kalaji Narayan Rao. So he was famously called as a popular, means the popular names is nothing but Kaloji, Kallanna, Kalaji Narayana, Prajakavi. These are the very famous names or the popular names of the Kalaji Narayan Rao. So Kalaji, Kallanna, Kalaji Narayana, Prajakavi. He was basically Indian poet. He's basically an Indian poet and he was a freedom fighter. He's also a freedom fighter and he was a political activist of the Telangana. So he was a political activist of the Telangana. So he was basically Indian poet and a freedom fighter and a political activist of the. He received the Padma Vibhushan Award in the 1992. So this was asked in the examination. So what are the awards he received? So he received the Padma Vibhushan in the year 1992. So he completed his primary education in Madikonda. In Madikonda place, he received the primary education and he received the higher education in the Warangal and the Hyderabad. So he completed his primary education in the Madikonda and he completed the higher education in Warangal and Hyderabad. So his birthday is 9th September is celebrated as the Telangana language day because he did so much of works in the Telugu. That's why his birthday is celebrated as a Telangana language day by the Telangana government. Honored his birthday as a Telangana language day. So because of his lots of work in the poetry, Telangana poetry, that is the reason his birthday is celebrated as a Telangana language day. Telangana language day. It was honored by the Telangana government. So 9th September is celebrated as a Telangana language day every year. So the famous books which are written by the Kalaji Narayan Rao is nothing but Anna Kathalu, Kalaji Kathalu, Parthiva Vijayam, Nagodova. Nagodova means my struggle. In English, Nagodova means my struggle. Tudi Vijayam, Manadi Vijayam. So out of all these things, this book is very, very important. This book is always asked in any competitive examinations. So in the examination, they'll ask, who wrote the book Nagodova? So the famous books written by the Kalaji Narayan Rao is nothing but Anakadalu, Kaloji Kadalu, Parthiva Vijayam, Nagodova, Tudi Vijayam, Manadi Vijayam. So these are the important books which are written by the Kalaji Narayan Rao. Out of all these books, Nagodova is a very, very asked, frequently asked in the competitive examinations. So these are the important facts of the Kalaji Narayan Rao. So by this lecture, you have successfully completed the 45 questions which are the previous year TSPSC general studies questions in a very detailed manner. If you like the content of our channel, then please do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon button. So whenever you upload a new video, the direct notification comes to your mobile. If any improvement is needed in the video lectures, then please do comment in the comment section. We will definitely include all those improvements in the coming lectures. Thank you so much for watching this lecture. Keep smiling. Take care and bye-bye.